most accurate meteorologist using the only live Doppler radar. Live Super Doppler HD, keeping you safe under an umbrella of protection.
Welcome back. A great day. Hope you got out and enjoyed it today. Temperatures once again soaring well into the 50-degree range, and good day to go out and do a little swinging. All right, let's head for the maps and take a look. Current temperatures still holding on to 52, 54 earlier today. We'll be heading down through the 40-degree point around midnight, down to the lower to mid-30s by 7 a.m. Temperatures around the region, oh, so nice. Fontanelle, 54. Ames at 50, Albia 53 degrees highs today. Those mid-50s extending all the way into north-central Iowa. Fog has been a problem all week long over the northeast. It continued today. Virtually, if you're on the east side of I-35, it's foggy up there. If you're on the west side, it is clear and warm. As we look at the satellite loop, especially the first part right in here, notice the cloud cover. That's the fog sitting down close to the ground. Now some higher clouds are streaming overhead, but this is not really the storm system we're tracking. That is still well down here across the southwestern section of the country, just starting to emerge over the last couple of hours. Now, there is a winter storm watch for areas just to the west of central Iowa, and that extends on into Nebraska and then dives into northern Kansas. Right now, this will probably be upgraded to some kind of advisory, especially for Nebraska and maybe into western Iowa. As you head out into central Nebraska, get down into northwestern Kansas and into Colorado, winter storm warning conditions. So much more serious if you're traveling toward Denver or getting out into western Nebraska tomorrow and on into Saturday. For us, again, we're just kind of right on the line of this system. We'll explain more in detail as we go through here. So initially, the system will lift up with heavy snow across central Nebraska. We'll be on the dry side of things. Easterly winds feeding in dry air, meaning most of tomorrow, we're just going to see clouds or occasional spurts of some light rain. As the moisture comes in, initially we'll have to turn whatever is in the form of rain. It looks like rain midday, but I think most of this will actually just go to making the clouds develop and get closer to the ground. As we head through the overnight, we'll probably get temperatures close enough to the freezing point to be able to see some light snow or mixed accumulation across central Iowa. But again, the heaviest amounts are going to be well out here in Nebraska. Then as we head into Saturday morning, as temperatures bump up maybe a degree or two above freezing, probably mix at times across central and southern Iowa with, again, the heaviest snows across Nebraska, the first couple of counties into southwest Iowa, and then dramatically tapering off as you get up north of I-80 to around Highway 30. The amounts through Saturday afternoon, not impressive for us. We'll still get more snow Saturday night, early Sunday, but at least the first part of the system, you can see out in Nebraska where they may get 10 inches, tapering off to 4 or 5 around Omaha, and then very little as you work your way north of I-80 and get up around Highway 30. So for us tonight, a quiet night, mid-30s, easterly winds 5 to 10. Temperatures tomorrow afternoon well above freezing, so we'll look for mainly light rain late. Then as we head overnight and early Saturday, that mix back and forth between some rain, sleet, or snow. And then on Sunday, temperatures in the mid-30s, a day to kind of clean up, especially western Iowa. It does not appear to be a high-impact event here in central Iowa, at least not yet. And then pretty well dry conditions persist through the next week. We'll be a little cooler with readings in the mid-30s, overnight in the teens and 20s. We'll continue to watch this, but right now if you're planning travel west into Nebraska or south into Kansas, would not be recommended on Friday.
Absolutely not. Thanks, John.
Time to beat the traffic.